Hi, I'm Xiaoyi.
Hi, I'm Oliver.
I am the co-playwright of City and Dog and one of the cast members.
I'm also the co-playwright and the director.
And this is
What's in a Scene? So in Citizen Dog, there are two worlds, the world of Mr. Pooh and the world of Xiaoyi. So Xiaoyi dreams up the world of Mr. Pooh and Mr. Pooh writes the world of Xiaoyi.
And the story was inspired by two source materials. One is the Liaozhai written by Bu Songling in Qing Dynasty. And the other one is when the government announced to take back the land in Lorong 3 Geylang when the current lease ends at the end of this year. That's the two instances.
And although we used a few names from the characters in Bu Songling's Liaozhai, we did not use any of his stories. So the stories are perfectly original.
But it's inspired by the themes and the spirit of the original novel, which is we use lots of supernatural characters to comment on our society.
So the theme of the play is about reality, right? And Mr. Pooh is a writer, he writes on paper. So the concept and theme, there's pretty much a lot of about paper. So you see the costume, paper, and then there's the study room behind. There are books written by Mr. Pooh. The costumes are also has this paper texture, paper quality. The dog is made to look like it is made out of paper. So the floor pattern on the floor is meant to mind you. So you would think that the floor pattern is run through like the whole set on the floor, but actually it's no. So it's actually a mirror that converges at the center. So it sort of messes it up a little when you look at it. Yeah.
And also paper items is usually what's burned as offerings to the dead in Chinese tradition. So it also brought on another layer for the audience to question whether this world is real or is the afterworld.
无依无靠，身无分文的落难女子，一位离乡背井来谋生的外地人。我连总结费、房租、盘缠都是跟亲戚借来的，不幸遇上怀人，都被骗光了。如今连回乡的盘缠都不够了。外来人才，他们国经济之发展不错，他们不吃老苦，来到我国，无非是想奉献他们的爱心、血汗、劳力、才华、创意。
So the language style of this play is quite unique. It's something that we don't usually see in Singapore because we try to imitate the 半文半白, which is half classical, half vernacular language style of the Qing and Ming dynasty.
This is also in a way to pay homage to Mr. Pooh, Bu Songling.
Yeah. Yeah, and the four main characters, their language styles are also quite different. For example, like Mr. Pooh, played by me, is kind of neutral Mandarin. And Tai Chang in Bai Jia, played by Elvin, he put on a Singaporean Chinese accent. And Ashio, played by Li Xie, is trying to imitate
Southwestern China.
Yeah, Southwestern
Chinese
China.
Accent.
Yes. And of course, Joker. Xiaoyi, played by Joker, is the Malaysian Chinese accent.
Oh, and the dog speaks vulgarities, spews vulgarities
In what accent?
Throughout, in pretty much neutral accent.
Yeah.
Pretty much neutral.
Not Aukang or Ohio accent.
Yeah, no.
So it creates a sense of detachment because the language style is not something that we can hear on the street, but you also kind of, you can understand most of it, but it's also quite detached from our society.
And that's also because of the theme of the Citizen series, lah. Uh-huh. Right? The Citizen series is because we talk about different people coming from different parts of the world, new immigrants coming to Singapore to live together, which is why there's China, Malaysia, Singapore,
Taihua创意! 提拔他们,善待他们,保护他们, 尤其是协助那些落难的外地人,是我等应尽之责任。 我相信官府一定会法外施恩, 宽限一个月, 让阿修姑娘有所安身, 筹得盘缠, 平安回乡。 吴先生, 你看这主意如何?
不先生啊!
Okay, I'm supposed to talk about why Joe is in a bowl. So, it happened during rehearsal when she's actually... So actually, Xiaoyi, played by Joe, she's supposed to fall asleep so that we can... the world interchanged into Mr. Pooh's world, which is dreamed up by Xiaoyi. So Xiaoyi fall asleep on the table. There happened to be a bowl beside her, so... I just thought that she would look very cute with her face in the bowl. So that's how she ends up in the bowl. That's all.
Yeah.
Now, of course, then you can read more into it, lah.
Yeah. As long as we don't see her face, then she's kept human.
Don't tell her.
Okay.
啊，别说了，租给你便是。很好。 吴先生不愧是读书人，大作家，通情达理。 我回头禀告官府，谢谢顾先生，谢谢大人。阿修姑娘，先别谢我，我还不知阿修姑娘所说的推拿按摩的本事是否属实。如果本官知道你糊弄我，本官一定会秉公办理，将你押回官府。Okay,
so why there is a dog in City and Dog?
For obvious reason.
Okay, first of all, because there are a few stories when there is a black dog appear in Liaozhai original novel. But then we decided to change the color to white because
it's easier to see a white dog on stage than a black dog.
Wow. Yeah.
Right.
And also because it's a way to emphasize the papery element.
Yeah, right? We rarely see paper in black, lah.
Yeah, right.
The dog is there to also keep the two characters company, right? Mr. Pooh and Xiaoyi, because they're pretty much alone. Xiaoyi is in the bowl but hidden behind. So Xiaoyi has a dog. Mr. Pooh has a dog. So the two dogs are actually the same dog. So the two worlds are actually connected by the dog. And so the dog is the embodiment of everything that's evil and everything that's kind. So as you can see, as the story unfolds, nobody in the world, in these two worlds, are actually kind. At the end of the day, the dog is the one who is the kindest.
And the dog is also the only character or existence crosses these two worlds without changing its costume and physicality.
It spews vulgarity in both worlds. Same amount of vulgarity.
Right.
It's the most popular character. Mr. Pooh and Xiaoyi, their colors are more pale, closer to white, as opposed to the other characters like the officer, who is played by Alvin Cham. Ashio played by Li Xie. She's in purple. So they are like intruders. So intruders are in brighter colors than the two protagonists.
And that's all for today. Thank you for watching.
We come back tomorrow.
Yeah, talking about coming back. Yes, if you are interested to find out the third installment of our trilogy, which is Season X, is coming back next year. And you can go to our website,
www.fingerplayers.com. Yeah, and really watch out for it because it was cancelled. Yeah, but it's coming back.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay.
Maybe let's end on like a bye or.
Oh, yeah, right.
Bye!